Bitcoin has solved the issues of decentralization and security. The Lightning Network solves the issue of scalability. This is Libertarian View, your source of decentralized and distributed information. Bitcoin stores information inside some sort of virtual ledger, the blockchain, distributed among the network's nodes which verify the financial transactions and store them irreversibly. This network assures that there are no double spending. In other words, nobody can spend their bitcoins more than once. If that happened, it would cease to be scarce and it would not be viable as a currency. That said, which are the desired features to this blockchain? There are mainly three: decentralization, security, and scalability. There is only one problem. Given the definition of those three features, it is impossible to have them all at the same time. To achieve two of them, the third will necessarily be sacrificed. Which prompts the question, which one? How about decentralization? No way. Only through it is it possible to separate our money from the state. Decentralization allows money to be used by the people and for the people, preventing them, the overlords, from stealing from us, the individuals. It also prevents censorship and, in the end, ensures inviolability of property. Every time money has allowed some level of centralization, it has happened. Once centralized, it is easy to manipulate monetary policies in favor of those in power. Centralized money, even an electronic one, is no match for the state-owned rifles. Bitcoin was designed in such a way that even a slowly computer can run a full node. There are tens of thousands of those nodes in the network, which makes it extremely resistant. Decentralization is therefore imperative and unnegotiable. Security then. Don't even think about it. Remember that money has three uses: as a storage of value, counting unit, and means of exchange. In all these uses, it is necessary that money is safe, protected from fraud or falsification. For someone to trust in a certain currency, security is central. In the Bitcoin network, the nodes are constantly verifying all the transactions and ensuring their authenticity. A transaction which differs from what is registered in the blockchain, that virtual ledger, is utterly ruled out. Maybe there is nothing as safe as Bitcoin's blockchain. In all its history, there hasn't been a single successful attack despite the many attempts. Security is also unnegotiable. Well, if decentralization and security are essential features for the blockchain, there is nothing left to do except to sacrifice scalability, right? Yes, that is right. Scalability measures the ability of a system to keep its features while supplying for an increased demand. In other words, when a system is scalable, it may continue to run in the same way as more people use it. To guarantee the decentralization and security in the Bitcoin's blockchain, the blocks must be small, and the rate of transactions per second must be limited. The goal of Bitcoin has never been to process millions of financial microtransactions per second. Its main objective, and much more important by the way, was to replace central banks. Satoshi Nakamoto himself has made this clear when he wrote, quote, "The root of conventional currency problems is all the necessary trust to make it work. The central bank should be reliable to not depreciate the currency, but history of fiduciary currencies is teeming with cases of betrayal to that trust." Close quote. This is the real problem. Fix the money, fix the world, as the song goes. This is also the problem that Bitcoin solves. To solve it, it was necessary to choose decentralization and security over scalability. However, that does not mean that there is no solution for scalability. In the same way, financial entities like Visa and MasterCard solve the scalability issues for central banks, Bitcoin finds a solution in second-layer protocols. Let's try to understand what a second layer is. Imagine that I trust you and you trust me and that we regularly send bitcoins to each other as a payment for products and services. Instead of registering each transaction we make in the blockchain, that main virtual ledger, we can keep our own smaller ledger, including only our transactions. In this ledger, we keep record of all transactions completed between us. Say that we have completed 10 operations this month, and in the end of the period, I am owing you 1 million satoshis. Instead of recording 10 transactions with all the details in the blockchain, we will register a single exchange of 1 million satoshis from me to you. The most important second layer protocol currently is the Lightning Network. The parallel ledgers containing the transactions among trusted peers are called channels. Every member of a channel deposits a set amount that stays there as a balance, as in a prepaid card. Any value lower than that basic balance can be sent instantly and cheap to another member of the channel. Sender and receiver both sign the transaction, validating it. If there is any dispute, the transaction is not registered and the balances remain unchanged. A member of the channel can choose to leave the channel. When that happens, the balance is verified and registered in the blockchain. The channels also connect with each other, allowing transactions among everyone within the second layer. The Lightning Network, running over the Bitcoin network, benefits from its decentralization and security. Besides, thanks to those channels, the network guarantees liquidity for cheap and instant payments, granting Bitcoin a good level of scalability. It also improves privacy because it uses topology, like the Tor network. Nowadays, anyone can start setting up their own Lightning Network system from home, like Jack Mallers, who just at his 20s founded Zap and Strike. Once the network is open, all improvements and updates set by anyone in the planet automatically affect the whole network. The possibilities are endless. Micropayments for games, microtransactions between different countries, self-service machines, and so on. The total balance of Bitcoins locked in the Lightning Network has been growing exponentially. In the last 2 months alone, it has increased over 50%. This is the network that will allow the population of El Salvador to use Bitcoins in their daily activities, getting rid of that monopoly game cash which people still call dollar. With the Lightning Network, it is possible to send cents instantly with rates nearing zero to anyone and anywhere in the world. Think about Afghanistan, where the banks have been closed and to where Western Union has suspended all payments. The Lightning Network is a solution to the average citizen in the country. Bitcoin and its second layers, like the Lightning Network, will provide true financial freedom to those looking for an escape route from the Leviathan. Ideally, digital currency should be decentralized, safe, and scalable. However, it is only possible to ensure two of these features. Bitcoin has sacrificed scalability in favor of the other two, and in that, it has done well. Its scalability can be achieved through the second layers, among which the most important is the Lightning Network. Thank you for your audience. This article was originally written by Jaraguá and Marco Battaglia. Reviewed by Coreia Conká, translated and narrated by Arthur Silvani. If you like this video, please hit the thumbs up icon below and share the video in your social network. If you want to be notified of other videos, hit subscribe and then the bell icon. See you soon!